and just spilled everywhere.
Picture this. You just had a bad day at your 9-to-5 job and need to find a way to unwind. But this time, you don't care about the hangover. You're ready to start getting rowdy and committing some street crimes. That's why today I've assembled a group of townies and college dropouts to inform you on the best video games that pair well with crystal alcohol. With marijuana and video games, I wanted to highlight games that had relaxing elements to them and that were pretty easy to play. In contrast, today we're going to be focusing on games that are hyper-intense and reward chaotic behavior. The first of which is Doom Eternal.
For it is he that they fear, not man, or his armies. They fear the mark of the beast.
There are a few games out there that can match the intensity of Doom Eternal's gameplay. Doom 2016 had some great moments, but Doom Eternal takes everything from that original game and amplifies it tenfold. New gameplay elements like the dash mechanic and the monkey bars make every environment feel like a playground for you to run around in. Crank that difficulty up a little bit, and you're gonna get nice and tipsy every time you have to take a swig when you die. This game also has two weapon mods that you can actively switch with during combat, and I just found that Sober Andy was less likely to experiment with the weapon mods, and Drunk Me was more like... There's a lot of great third-person, action-packed slashers. Personally, I was really torn with putting either God of War 3 or Metal Gear Revengeance on this list. Both titles are great revenge stories in their own right, but I think God of War 3 just beats out Metal Gear from the non-stop boss fights that you come in contact with. And these aren't just your average Joe boss fights. These are huge and epic boss fights with every major god of the Greek pantheon. It almost feels like a sporting event with every battle that you get in. And can we go back to that soundtrack for a minute?
The man, the legend, Kratos, will have his revenge.
You can't not listen to the introduction music and not get extremely motivated to kill every member of your family. I recently replayed this game with a soundbar on full blast, and that is the only way I will ever play this game. Coupled with all the things that Kratos went through in the first game, you just really feel like Kratos is getting his revenge in the best possible way. Online multiplayer games will always mix really well with alcohol, especially ones that you can play with your friends. Alcohol definitely increases my competitiveness when it comes to these games.
I have reached the objective.
Yeah! Let's go!
But again, there's an insane amount of these titles, so here are just a few honorable mentions. Hey, look, it's another Greek pantheon game. Except this time it's less about killing them and more about f***ing them. Hades is probably my favorite roguelike game of all time, and I found it mixed very well with alcohol. There's tons of drinking game potential when it comes to this one. Things like drinking every time you take damage, or drinking every time someone calls Zag a nickname.
Hail, noble cousin.
Hey there, Zag man, how's it going?
Stupid boy.
Nice place you got here, boyo.
Or even drinking every time Dio comes on screen. The possibilities are honestly endless, and it helps that the gameplay is fun as hell too. If you want even more challenge, you can turn on the game limiters to make gameplay even more intense. I personally don't need that challenge, because even after 90 hours in, I still struggle to make it out of hell in one run. Most Nintendo games are aimed for every audience, but there is a lot of them that pair well with drinking. While Smash Bros. And Mario Party are really great contenders, I have to give this one to Mario Kart. Mario Kart is just such a good game for everyone to play. It doesn't have the high skill ceiling that's associated with Smash Bros., and it doesn't have the luck aspect that comes with Mario Party. Depending on the people that you hang out with, Mario Party can really sour the atmosphere if you're not careful. That's why I think Mario Kart is the best of both worlds. Whether it's the newest entry or one of the retro games, it's hard to go wrong when choosing. Personally, I'm like the guy who hangs out with the dog at the party the whole time, but the dog is Mario Kart. There's a lot of interesting things you can do for a drinking game with Mario Kart. The really intense one is the drunk driving rule, where you have to stop your cart when you want to take a drink and you have to finish that drink by the end of the race, or taking a drink for every time you get hit with a certain item. I personally plan on making my own rules very soon. But again, Mario Kart is a great game to mix with drinking, even if you don't have your own rules with it. So obviously drinking in video games isn't going to be for every single person, but I do recommend at least trying it once with one of the games that I mentioned here. It personally gets me in a really competitive and rowdy spirit that I wouldn't normally have sober. And like I said in the previous video, just like with mixing marijuana in video games, don't do it excessively. Just don't do it, man. Come on. If you haven't already, be sure to check out my Twitch channel, as that's where I'm going to be streaming the Mario Kart 8 drinking game this month, where you can watch me and all my debauchery and rowdy behavior. Everyone had a lot of great comments on my last video on some of their experiences with marijuana in video games, and I'd love to hear your experiences with alcohol in video games on this one. But either way, thanks for watching, and until next time.